So the students who got the rank above 5,000 were also there at CBIT MBA program. So you need not worry at all. So you can happily apply for management quota and you're going to get admitted into the MBA program at CBIT because this is very, like, you know, minimum rank 3,000, it's not that a huge rank. So it's fine, you are going to get admitted into CBIT, so trust me and all the best. So coming to next question, it's from Dhanalakshmi Panjala. Okay, hi Dhanalakshmi. Coming to your question, please make the video on top B pharmacy colleges in Hyderabad for by PC stream. I'm surely going to not make a video. I'm surely going to tell here itself why. Why to make a video separately? I'm going to tell you here itself. Just stay tuned a minute. I'm going to tell you all the important. Yes. So I'm going to tell you the top B Pharm colleges in Hyderabad based upon the recent ranking, that is based upon the 2019 ranking. So let's see. The first most best college is Birla Institute of Technology and Science, which is also called as BITS Hyderabad campus. Okay, BITS Hyderabad is one of the best college in Hyderabad. And second college is Vivekananda Group of Institute, which is also called as VGI, which is in Hyderabad. It is also one of the best BPharm college. And next, Geetham, as usual, it's one of the best. Geetham School of Pharmacy and CMR College, Jawaharlal Nehru University, like JNTU, and few more other colleges are also there. So these are the one of the best, like few of the best colleges you can happily studying. Okay, so let's see next question. The question is from Sunita Jinka. Hi Sunita, when will we have to pay the counseling fee? Okay, so I think you're asking counseling fee for API set. Okay, when will we have to pay the counseling fee for API set? Yes, I'll tell you just a second. Yeah, so coming to the counseling fee, you need to pay the counseling fee while registration. The official date is not been declared yet, so it will be mostly in July. Yeah, mostly in July. In second week or first week, based upon the counseling and the certificate, like all the stuff. So coming to the API set counseling dates, it will be starting from July second week. Web counseling will be from July second week as well, or maybe from July third week also. So coming to the API set 2019 counseling fee, for SC and ST it will be 600 rupees, and coming to any other caste it's going to be 1200 rupees. So there's no official announcement of you know, any particular counseling application forms and all. So you need to pay the application fee when, like, while registration. Okay, while registering yourself for the ISET counseling, you need to pay the counseling fee. Okay, so all the best. So coming to next question is from Shamaira. Okay, hi Shamaira. My TS LSAT rank is 1965. Okay, so which college you will get? Okay. Okay, so I will answer all the TS LSAT queries once at a time in in few minutes because related like TS law set related questions there are 4 to 5. I can't keep answering each and every question, so at the end of the sec I can't tell the end of the session also. Within 2 to 3 minutes I'm going to answer all your questions. Okay, so Shamaira, stay tuned, keep watching. Within few minutes I'm going to answer your question. So Viraj Yadav, okay, he also asked the same TS LSAT question. Hello ma'am, I have appeared for TS LSAT 2019. I scored 66 marks and my rank is 439. Congratulations. So my caste is BC. I am expecting admission in Mahatma Gandhi colleges. Is it possible? Okay, I'll answer your question also within few minutes because all TS LSAT TS LSAT 2019 questions I am packing and will answer you all at a time. Stay tuned, you also, Viraj. Okay, so coming to Vikas, yes, this particular question I'll answer specially at last of this study related questions. Okay, so coming to Sanjay Verma, my AIR in AIIMS is 7127. Can I get a college? As you got 7127, it's really hard for you to get the college because especially the rank AIIR should be at least below 1200. So I'm sorry, it's tough to get you a college with this particular AIIR. I'm sorry, Sanjay. So coming to the next question, Jio Creations. Okay, hi Jio Creations. Are these questions important for BCA Calicut, Calicut University? As I told you in the very starting of my video of this video, so if your syllabus and if the important questions which I have given you matches, then you can happily follow them. Because I didn't do that important questions for any particular university, it was generally for everybody who has that syllabus. Okay, so based on that, you can happily follow. So, coming to next question, ma'am, I am SC candidate. Okay, sorry, I didn't read out the name, it's from Deepak Verma. Hi, Deepak, ma'am, I am SC candidate. My AIIR is 2,01,077. Sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. It's 21,077. I'm sorry, I have read it as 2 lakhs. I'm sorry, Deepak. Ma'am, I'm SC candidate. My AIIR is 21,077. My SC rank is 484. So, what are my chances of getting admission in AIIMS? Okay, nice question. I'm going to answer you this question. And next question is from Shubham, similar question. Ma'am, I am from SC candidate. I am SC candidate. My AIIMS AIIR is 19,602, SC 440. Can I get in any of the college? Ma'am, please reply. Okay. So coming to the both students who are Deepak and Shubham, I am answering both of you in general. So yes, this is one of the most important question which hundreds of students have been asking me. So first, coming to 2019, I'm going to tell you the official cutoff released by AIIMS. Okay, so let's see the cutoff percentile for general category is 98.1246. Okay, I'm repeating, the cutoff percentile score for general category has been declared as 98.1246, and for OBC and unreserved PWD category students, the cutoff is 95.29, and for SC, ST, PWD, the cutoff is 82. And AIIMS MBBS cutoff, the official qualification cutoff is for percentile and percentage as well. For general, the percentage, qualifying percentage is 50% and percentile is 98.12 for general. Coming to SCST, the qualifying percentage is 40% and qualifying percentile is 90. Coming to OBC, minimum qualifying percentage is 45 and percentile is 95.29. So based upon these things, you can estimate your colleges as well as ranks and all. So as I can't answer separately for each and every student, I read out the official cutoff things and all. Okay. So coming to next question. Laya Verma. Okay. Hi, Laya Verma. Ma'am, YPC stream ki online application date enti. Okay. For YPC stream, you're asking online application date. I'm going to tell you just a second. It's not for YPC or MPC. I'm going to tell you the official application dates for TS MCA 2019. Coming to the online application date, but okay, you didn't mention properly. I was thinking it's for exam. Exam is already been done. Okay, so I think you're asking for counseling. Am I correct? Okay, so that's why please put your questions clearly. I am getting confused reading some questions. So sir, ma'am, so YPC stream ki online application date empty. So it will start by June last week. You need to register yourself, and after registering you have to pay the application fee. The fees will be different for normal candidates and SCST candidates and unreserved candidates as well. And after that you need to pay your counseling fees based upon your category, and the reservation is the unreservation. After that, what you need to do is you have to fill the application form by choosing the colleges which in which colleges you would love to get into, and in which courses you wanted to get into. And you should also mention them like second, third priority colleges also, like first priority of college. If you don't get into this, what is the second priority college which you would like to get into? So after all that, they'll be officially, they'll just declare the counseling dates based upon the ranks. So after that, you need to, there'll be the a document verification session. There you need to carry your admit card, your educational certificates, original educational certificate, Xerox also I suggest you to carry with you. Xerox also, like at least 2 to 3 copy Xerox of each and every educational certificate. And you should also carry your photocopy, such as Aadhaar card or PAN card, driving license, anything. And you should also carry 4 to 5 photocopies, recent passport sized photocopies. And you should also carry the result, the rank card of the MZ or IZ, whatever it might be. So that's it. After that, you'll be admitted. You will be allocated to a college based upon your priority. So if you're still not happy with the admitted, like the college which you got in counseling, you can go to the spot counseling as well. So that's it. Okay. So coming to the next question. Ready? Renka Raju. Okay, hi Renka. I got 804 rank in TS-Lauzet. See, I have told you I have 4-5 questions from regarding TS-Lauzet. So Rinka, I am going to answer you this question within few minutes. So next question is from Fazil Khan. Hi Fazil Khan. Ma'am, I have finished a BCA, MCA 3 years or 2 years, which is best? Okay, so as your BCA, Bachelor of Computer Applications, you can happily go to the course of MCA 2 years. For the students who are not from BCA, for them there's a course with MCA 3 years where you need to have mathematics or statistics in your degree, either your degree or your plus two. Okay, so as you're from BCA, you can happily go out to MCA 2 years thing, and if you feel you can also go to 3 years, but I suggest you to go to MCA 2 years. It's enough for you because you have almost done with more than half of MCA course. As you're from BCA, the similar subjects, similar contents and all, so it's fine, and you can happily manage by going to the MCA 2 years. But the only thing is, choose one of the best colleges, because most of the colleges, I suggest you not to go to MCA in the college where there's no value for MCA. Okay, always choose one of the best college for MCA. Okay, so coming to next question, I got 94 marks. Okay, fun with me. The name of the person is Fun with Me. Okay, hi Fun with Me. I got 94 marks in TS ISET. What is my rank? Okay, in TS ISET, you got 94 marks. So your rank will be below 6,000, approximately below some 5,000 to below 5,000, and I can't tell you exactly. I don't have idea of the exact rank because ranks every year keep changing. So the rank will be below 4,500. The next question is from Sai Lalita Pranati. Hi Sai Lalita Pranati. A question is very long. Oh my God. It's like an essay. So let's see the question. Ma'am, what is the difference between supplementary and a backlog? Are these both the same? Backlog are the subjects which you failed in, so that is called a backlog. Supplementary is the exam which you're going to write. It's a kind of re-exam. Okay, once you fail in the mains, you write re-exam, so that exam is called supplementary. So I am studying the same question continuation. I am studying degree BSc Computers, MPCS group. Right now I completed my first year. I wrote 2 semesters, as there are 2 semesters per year in degree. If anyone fails in any of the semester subject, will the failure affect the future of his or her? I mean, will backlog affect his career or her career? Please clarify my doubt, because in few days my second sem results will come, and I am so much worried about my C language subject. Okay, so coming to your question, it's one of the genuine and best question. I feel it's heartfelt question. I really loved your question and the way you asked. So coming to Lalita, you are studying BSc MPCS, so, and you said you have a backlog. So you know, backlog does not affect anybody's career, trust me. Because okay, just it's yeah, I just wanted to tell this thing from many many days. So finally I'm going to tell this. See, for example, take my scenario. Since 10th to my PG, I have maintained 80%. But nobody asked me, do you have backlogs or, you know, like something like, or nobody told me, oh, so great that it's 80%, 85%. And I was the college topper in CBIT, NCA. I received Academic Excellence Medal. But the thing is, nobody cares that, okay? At the end of the day, you should, like once you complete your course, it might be 10th or inter or, you know, degree, BTech, whatever it might be. At the end of the last semester, it's better to you, it's better for you to have no backlogs, okay? So it's fine to have backlogs till the last second semester, but make sure you does not carry them to the last semester, because I suggest you not to carry the backlogs to the final year, because final year you'll be having placements, so few companies will not allow the students with backlogs. So that's the only thing which you need to worry. So make sure you deal with all your backlogs before the final year. Than final semester, it's better to clear all your backlogs before final year. So that's the one thing I want to tell you. And the second thing is, you need not worry about the C language, because, you know, if you just write theory also, you're easily going to pass, trust me. And I already made C language important questions on my channel long ago, before 1 year. Just go and check them out. You can easily pass, trust me. And so coming to backlogs affect his career or her career? Backlogs are not going to affect anybody's career, because most of the students will have backlogs, and at the end of the day, you need to be confident in clearing the backlogs. That's the only suggestion I would love to give you. And you know, it's fine. As you are in degree now, I suggest you to maintain at least 60%, because any company from the small company to the topmost IT, any company, take any company, it will just see whether you have 60% or not. That's all, okay? For that company, it's same though you have 60% or 100%, okay? So what you need to do is, I suggest you to maintain at least 60% clear all your backlogs before final year. So you need not worry, it's fine. It's fine to have backlog. It's fine to have a career, or like, you know, failures in the career. Even in the morning IIIT session which I attended, they were telling that only, like, all the CEOs who sat there told them their failure story. To, you know, it's not just to motivate thing. I'm not just telling you to motivate or something. It's fact, okay? You can't expect the success always. It's fine to have failures, okay? Just go with the flow, and you need not worry. All the best, okay? So coming to next question is from SB Pavani. Hi SB Pavani. Ma'am, I got 270 marks. Which MBBS college can I get? Please reply, ma'am. So you didn't mention whether it is like which entrance exam. Is it NEET or AIIMS? You didn't mention it. So I can't answer your question, because coming to 270, you need to mention. You need to really mention for what exam you got 270 marks. I'm confused with the question, so I'm sorry, I can't reply. Next question is from Sur Reddy Prasad Reddy. Okay, hi Sur Reddy Prasad Reddy. MBA lo EBC ki scholarship enta vastadi madam? So I don't know exact figure of the amount you get as a scholarship, but I'm sure for MBA you are going to get scholarship. But the amount decides upon the college you choose and based upon the reservation category as well. Okay. So coming to next question. Next question is from Vikas Kumar Perumula. Hi Vikas Kumar. NIT Warangal, will it accept ISET? Okay, question is, will Warangal NIT, will NIT Warangal accept ISET? No, it does not accept. Unfortunately, NIT Warangal will not accept ISET admissions. In order to get into NIT Warangal, you need to write MAT or CAT, MAT or CAT. CAT, you know, it's very famous. MAT stands for Management Aptitude Test. So only through these two things, NIT Warangal will accept admissions. It will not accept admissions through ISET. So I'm sorry. So coming to next question is from Sai Krishna. I got 29th rank. Can I expect in Osmania? Yes, absolutely. You can expect in Osmania because it is one of the least ranked. So you can happily get through Osmania. There's no doubt in it. So yes. Now let's see the ISET, TS LOSET, not ISET, TS LOSET questions, related questions. Yes, so coming to the people who asked me, like for TS LOSET, which college is better, which university is better for them all, I'm going to tell you the common answer. So coming to TS LOSET, I will also tell you the cutoff, don't worry, and even the reservation category and the unreservation category cutoff as well. So coming to the Andhra Mahila Sabha College, Hyderabad. For open category, the cutoff rank is 3000. For BC, BCA category, the cutoff rank is 6000. For BCB, it is 6500. And for BCD, it was 4000. Sorry, for BCA, it was 6300. Okay, for BCB, it was 6200, and for BC, C and D, it was 4000. For SC, it was 6368. For ST, it was 7500. Coming to the Aurora Legal Sciences Academy, Hyderabad, for open category, the cutoff is 2000 for male, and for open category female, the cutoff for Aurora's Legal Sciences Academy, the cutoff is 7000. And coming to the BC, the rank, the cutoff rank is in between 7000 to 8000. For SC, the rank will be 6000 cutoff rank, and for ST, it will be 8000. Okay, so coming to the Dr. Ambedkar College of Law, which is in Hyderabad. For open category male, the cutoff is 3000. For female, it is 4000. For BC, it is 4500. For SC, the cutoff is 2500. And for ST, the cutoff rank is 2500 for male and 8000 for female. Okay. So one more college, which is one of the most famous college, is Mahatma Gandhi Law College. Coming to open category for male, it was the cutoff rank was 9800. For female, it was 4500. For BC, it was 5000. For SC, it was 6000. For ST, it was 6,500. Okay, so I hope I answered your question. And this there is this one special question which I need to answer really specially. This particular question is from Vikas Vasist. This particular person, this particular subscriber of mine, is the rank 1 holder in TS Lawset 2019. A huge round of applause for this person. I'm very happy for you, Vikas Vasist. So his question is, I have rank 1 in TS Lawset. Which college to target for law? 3 years LLB. Which university is better? Okay, whether it is BHU, DU or Punjab University. Okay, nice question. So coming to the ranking of 2019, the first best college is National Law School of India, which is in Bangalore, and then National Law University, New Delhi, and then NAL SAR University of Law, which is in Hyderabad. So these three colleges has the topmost ranking. I'm not telling my own ranks. So these three are the topmost colleges. First is National Law School of India, which is in Bangalore, and National Law University New Delhi, and NAL SAR University of Law in Hyderabad. And the fourth topmost college is Faculty of Law University, Delhi. Okay, so based upon these things, you can decide which college to select, which and all. So once again, very very happy for you. Congratulations, Vikas Vasist. So now let's see. Most of the students ask me what are the topmost colleges for TS ISET. So let's see. Coming to the first college, Indian Institute of Management, Visakhapatnam is the best. And then ICFAI Business School, Hyderabad is the best. So these two are the topmost management colleges. And now let's see personal questions. We are done with the educational related questions. So now let's see the personal questions. I have selected only 5 questions. So first question is, are you on social media? No, I am not on any social media. I don't follow any social media and all stuff like that. I'm not on Facebook, I'm not on Twitter, Instagram, nothing, just on YouTube. Next question, were you a good student? I was always been a good student since my childhood. I used to respect teachers a lot. I used to study. I used to never bunk. A good student, basically. So, third question, which was one of the unique question I selected. So, this particular question, why did I select this particular question is that it's imaginary question and it was funny. So that's why I selected this particular question. What will you do if you get $1 million? Yes, good question. I hope, first of all, I hope I get $1 million. If I get, I can happily go to world tour. I would love to go to world tour. So I hope I get $1 million. Okay. So the fourth question, last two questions. The fourth question is, what are the three unknown things about you? Okay, three unknown things about me. The first unknown thing about me is I am an open book to my close people. The people who know me very closely knows everything about me. I'm an open book to them. And the second unknown thing about me is I'm super, super, super close to my grandparents, my mother's parents. I'm very close to them since my childhood. And the third unknown thing is I draw scenery, I draw nature. I basically draw, not like a pro, but I am a good artist, I can tell. Okay. So the fifth and the final question is, what is your biggest secret? How can I tell you my biggest secret? If I tell you, why will it be your biggest secret? Okay, so I'm sorry, I'm not going to tell you. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such videos. And there's a giveaway contest. Now I'm going to announce it. I'm going to tell you what is the contest all about. So coming to the this giveaway contest, first of all, let me tell you what will the lucky winners win. Okay, so the lucky winners, the three lucky winners are going to win best way to study t-shirts. Okay, so that's the contest prize, gift, whatever you say, giveaway. So what you need to do to win the giveaway contest is that first you need to subscribe to my channel Best Way to Study, and second you need to hit the bell icon to get the notifications. First subscribe, second hit the bell icon. Once you click on subscribe, you'll see a bell icon, click on that. Third, share this video with three of your friends and put that screenshot in the comment section below, or you can happily, actually what you need to do is you need to subscribe and hit the bell icon and then comment in the comment section below with the name hashtag giveaway. Okay, then I'll understand that you have subscribed to my channel and also you have hit the bell icon. And the third thing I told you is to share this video to three particular, like three of your friends or three of your relatives, anybody, and that screenshot mail me to my mail address, which is best way to study 7@gmail.com. It's number 7, not SEVEN, it's just number 7. Okay, I'm repeating the mail address, best way to study 7@gmail.com. So all the very best for the contest. So, and other thing which I would love to tell you is, from today, you can happily buy Best Way to Study t-shirts. What you need to do is you just have to mail me that you are interested to purchase Best Way to Study t-shirts. The price is super cheap. It's just 499 rupees. It's one of the biggest dream come true, because wearing Best Way to Study t-shirts is it's something which I'm dreaming since long. Finally it's happening. I'm glad for that. So that's it for today. If you want to win the merchandise for free, three lucky winners will be selected and will be given Best Way to Study free t-shirts. And you need to do is subscribe, hit the bell icon, and share this video with any three of the friends or people. And if you want to buy this Best Way to Study t-shirts, then you need to mail me and the mail address is also in the description below. You can happily check them out, check it out, and you can happily mail me that you are interested to buy the t-shirts. You need to tell me the number of t-shirts you would like to get, and you can happily buy the t-shirts. Okay, that's all for today. Don't forget to like and share this video. Don't forget to hit the bell icon. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. This is our channel. So soon let's reach 10,000 subscribers. Love you all. Thanks for watching my video. Thanks.